I would say that T. Rowe Price is very thoughtful about being inclusive. What anybody does should not be discriminatory against anyone. Everyone should be included. Everyone should be a part of the whole.
I participated in one of the forums that Pride put together, and Dr. Steve Robbins was there and talked a lot about the neuroscience of inclusion. And I found that to be very powerful, that if people don't feel included, that the portions of their brain that light up with regard to physical pain appear. And so you think about when you're in pain, emotionally or physically, can you really commit yourself to the role and the work you're doing?
I've worked in environments where people were not accepted because of who they were. I've had friends where we've had to create fabulous backstories and go to parties together because they couldn't be honest with who they were at work. And that's not a good environment for anyone to have. And it's why I'm an ally. I think it is critical in this day and age for an employer to be welcoming to all.
We have enough to worry about with work and the pressures of doing a good job and having your regular life. And I don't think anyone or anybody in the community needs to feel additional pressure about being themselves and coming to work and being fully involved and engaged and sharing their experiences in an open way. I think that's really important.
There is never a moment where a straight person tells you about their boyfriend, their girlfriend, their husband, their wife, their children. No one blinks an eye. And no one should have to feel that they cannot disclose that, you know, they're a gay man and they have a husband, or they're a lesbian and they have a wife.
I actually worked with a young lady years ago, and we all knew she was gay, but she never let anyone know she was gay. And it hurt me because we were able to come in from the weekend and talk about the things we did with our families, our husbands, significant others, and she wasn't. And it wasn't until years later that she came out, and I went into her office after she did, and we both cried because I told her. I said that was the worst kept secret in the department, and I was so glad that she was able to feel comfortable enough to come out, and to this day, we're still friends.
As far as telling other people, I had really grappled with how much I wanted to talk about this, not from a fear or anything like that, but just more of the fact that this was a private thing for me, necessarily, and I didn't know, as a parent of a trans person, just how applicable that would be. The reality is that the creation of the Pride group and the Pride activities that has gone beyond it, you know, kind of led me to a place that when I was approached, it felt like there was already a community there. There was already an infrastructure in place, that even if it was focused mostly on gay and lesbian issues, I still haven't met a whole lot of trans folks here at T. Rowe, but that the environment would be open and it would be welcoming. I had no idea, from an interest and welcoming point of view, how well that turned out.
If our LGBTQ associates can come to work and feel that they can actually be themselves, they're gonna be able to bring their best because they're gonna feel good. And that's really what this is all about, is all of us working together and doing great things together. That's our environment, it's a collaborative environment.